Hey, my friends, welcome back. It is Star Wars Wednesday. We're on week two, Jedi Outcast part five? I start to lose count after a while. but we are on the planet of Bespin doing the next mission. We finally got our force heal, and let's jump into it. Let's get to it. Don't forget, we are playing with the HD pack today. So we're going to get some of those high texture bonuses. So keep that in mind when you watch. Open it. There we go. Here's how it works. Press F or whatever key you use for that particular force power, and then you just have to sit there and regenerate. And yeah, you need a certain amount of minimum just to turn it on. And then it still only gives you about 25 per force bar, at least this early on. Later on, I think that you don't have to move, and you can later on you don't have to hold still. Oh, I did not save, but okay.
Huh?
I bet I could probably use force speed to get across fast. So it's like a lot of damage. Just, there we go. No? Okay, that could be bad. forward. It's okay. Luckily, healed is our friend now. I mean, yeah, there's a little bit of a wait time, but with it, you can... Well, you can accomplish wonders. I want this to be even super colder. Yeah, I know super colder isn't a word. Or a combination of words that should be put together, rather. I should have thought about that. I could just force push it off, and then I wouldn't have to worry about it, but I was all like, no! Bastards. I knew as I got closer there might be something that would happen. So I'll have to be more careful this time if I'm going to go over and make sure I've got better health first. Things like that. Yeah. Why? Oh, that would have been terrible. Oh, okay, that's fine. I can still load here. That'll work. That was crazy. Adjust the camera a little bit. It's just not the way I'm gonna be able to go. There, and then what do I just do? A kind of reverse? It's probably jump up and then go back. Much back that you can get out of that. Yeah, that's what you gotta do. It's just a little bit of
a sense of disturbance in the force, but there's something strange about it.
Ooh, is it time for our first Jedi fight? Oh, yes. Here we go.
You will die. You will die.
Jumping
Do you
over?
Fear me?
In the butt. What? In the butt. What? Wrong button. Off with his head. Another one of you, yes. I know how to do your moves.
The force betrays you.
Get up here where we can both see.
You must be the droid Lando told me about.
Force push, force pull. That's different. Strange. Okay. Don't forget to check the previous day's videos to be able to see what today's video's cinematics usually have for this level. Camera is not behaving as well as I'd like. Hopefully you guys can see me pretty well. That's gotta be a mid-level transition, yeah. Force powers. Let's see. Force grip. That's good, but only when it powers up. Everything else looks to still be the same. A gun thing. Rest when you're dead. But you can save anytime. Oh, thank you. That's so kind. That's it? You're done? Okay. Until I get fast style. Fast style is the best, in my opinion, for taking out little guys. It's just quick, quick, quick. You know? And you have a better defensive precision with it, so. Heavy has its purpose too, but just, yeah. Go, kid.
The Force betrays you.
You don't have access to the Force. Apparently, I don't. You do. I know.
You must be Katarn. Lando sent us to help. We've got teams trying to take back this sector of the city, but it's no small task. The place is swarming with Relo's thugs. Our men will help you wherever they can. Good luck.
You too.
Thanks. You too.
You stay here, though, because I got this, buddy.
Hostile!
Die, buddy. I'll play tank. Come on, buddy. Let's keep moving. I got you. How is your lightsaber defense and everything updates? You actually have the chance to dodge that crap. Just hit him. Thank you. Alright. Let's take a moment to regenerate. Bring ourselves back. We want to save our back to tanks for when we're in deep crap and we're not in combat. What a dog. One of the dogs is always coming in here. It's Cacao. Hey, Cacao, are you going to say hi to the people on the camera? Come here, Cacao. He's got a spray collar on. because he's a troll on Travis Park. We don't want that. You put your pee-pee away? No pee-pee for the camera. Hmm. Are you being a good boy? Or are you being a naughty boy? Hmm? What you being? Ichuta. How rude. On down. They're down.
I'll stay here and see if I can get them out of the back.
Open fire!
Poor guy didn't make it.
We're with you.
Sorry, guys. Bad reaction. Sorry. I'll go back. I'll reload again. That was not cool. Not cool, guys. Sorry. Not cool with me. This time I will not attack you. I'll attack you too.
We're with you, Commander. Lead the way.
Awesome. You guys can move, buddy. If you don't move, you will all die. And you waste on the shields. Not gonna save scum through that, though.
Open fire!
I didn't even know that was called save scum to get it out of. I thought it was just called saving. No, there was such a connotation as a scum to be attached to saving. Nope, thought it was safe, I am not. On the roof, all the way up on the roof. Look how big these levels are, man. Boosted. I have a moment. I feel a lot more like a tank now. It took a while, you know, to get into it, but I feel more tanky. I can handle it. I can get in there and beat him up. And I like that. You can actually kind of do that already at the beginning of Jedi Academy, the sequel to this one. Not completely, but, you know, you start off with basic force powers. And so, and if memory serves, after the end of each mission in Jedi Academy, you actually have the option to upgrade what force power you want to upgrade. It's unlike the story-driven progression here. So you can start off automatically upgrading your heal power right away. And that's kind of what I like to do, because I feel like the heal really makes it more, you feel like that Jedi with the balancing of all the combat and so forth. So, not full health, but it's fine. Ooh, I sense a boss fight. Kinda.
Do you fear me?
This is gonna be fun. Even if they block your force power, if they block a push or something meant to get him to the ground, it's helpful because for a moment you force them into that position. They have to do that. One down. And so it's helpful to you as the attacker, because then you can control their overall movement. As long as you successfully, you know, cast push in the direction, forcing them to do that. And I prefer push over pull, because I don't want to accidentally bring their saber in close enough to strike me in the face. So, done. Nope. Also, in Jedi Academy, you can get different sounds for your saber, and of course different styles. You can have a single saber.
Pretty tricky.
I was not expecting that. You can have a single saber, you can have a dual bladed saber like Darth Maul, or you can have two individual sabers. In the multiplayer community there is a best, but in the single player community I'm not sure if there really is, like, if there's you know, pick this over any of the others. Me personally, I go with, my back. I like to go with, either the double-sided saber or just one singular saber, because each lightsaber style, quick, medium, and slow, they all have, they're all available on a single-bladed lightsaber, just a regular one like I'm holding here. But if you decide to go ahead and, what do you want to call it, if you decide to pick a dual-bladed lightsaber, like Darth Maul, then you're limited to normal and strong. And if you pick your two lightsabers, then you're limited to normal and quick. That's it. So you can go back to your one blade mode by either shutting one off by hitting the right button, or you can go back to your, you know, activating a button that'll shut off one side of it. But it's question, which one do you like better? Most duelists usually stick with the one. Figure out, Kyle. Well, then again, he doesn't really know about General Fire. Well, actually, shouldn't he know? Because earlier on in one of the missions, Dasan contacted Fire and let him know to do certain things, so. I think so, at least. I could be wrong. I don't mind losing health points anymore for the most part. I'm just like, don't make me lose shields. I killed you. There we go. Strong stance. You can see by the way he holds it, that is strong stance. He's not standard. Accidentally hit. Like, it was taking a long time. Luckily, I got him. It was taking a long time, but I kind of hit the right mouse button again. Right mouse is saber throw that automatically launches you out of the encounter, so gotta be careful about that. Really need a mouse that allows me to actuate them differently again. I used to have a Logitech G503, and I liked it, but then it broke. Kind of one of those faults of the design that happened to a lot of people. It starts to double click on its own and stuff, and it's no bueno, but found using this sort of half generic thing. Get it from out there. Okay. Where did I miss it? Thank you. Probably get more force powers again. Yep. Force Lightning and Lightsaber Defense 2. A large arc directly in front of him, increased deflection speed. Jedi launches a single bolt that fires forward, doing instant damage. That's helpful against the Sith, but it's better when it's fully upgraded, because right now, I mean, look, it's just a little, you know, it doesn't do like a full major amount, like, Palpatine. more likely to succeed in a force push or pull exchange, by the way, if you get them in the air or in the middle of a combat. Slick looking. Downside of it is when you're in that mode, you cannot regenerate vehicles. So you can actually deplete yourself all the way if you're not careful. Part 2? 3PO? What are you fools doing here? That must mean Luke's here. Most likely, right? Unless those are just. They look the same, but they aren't the same. See if the key was for back here. That little elevator thing over there? Is it for this? Oh no.
We got him.
Saber yourself back out, that's why I do that. There we go. Get should. So he's in quick form. Because there's a maneuver that you can do. Oh, it got me. There's a maneuver that you can do that, kind of a dash forward. But it only works, it only works in the quick form. Hiccups all of a sudden. It only works when you're in quick style. Quick form. A lot of clicking. I know technically, obviously, you can do this in Switch or what have you, you know, where it's like it's different. But, again, I have a Switch, and I love the damn thing. I can't record for you guys unless I, like, put this camera next to me while I'm playing it, and that's just. Who wants to watch someone do that? Not triggering that yourselves. Look at them, flick at that wrist. Jedi.
The prodigal Jedi. Have you come seeking vengeance? That's not very Jedi-like.
Where's your master, apprentice?
The Sun sends his regards, but is far too busy in the Valley of the Jedi to personally dispose of his pawns.
What?
You still don't know, do you? The Sun followed you to the Valley of the Jedi.
Puppies.
Even now, hundreds of Dasan's loyal followers are drinking deeply from the Valley's power, becoming reborn in the glory of the Force. And we owe it all to you.
Then you killed Jan.
That's right. We killed your woman to make you angry. Angry enough to cast aside your promises and rashly seek out the power of the Valley. Just think of it.
You're literally giving away all the plot.
Will be celebrated for eons to come as the events that brought about the era of Dasan. Congratulations.
Stop talking!
Oh, we're gonna go at it. This is a very non-sexual brow, but we're gonna take her down. She's a lot harder than the average. And if she falls off, she won't die. I expect the trolley to die to her once or twice. Good hit, good hit. The dismemberment, though, that's awesome. I guess we'll keep it third person. I like the whole first person thing a second ago, but I think you guys might find it more entertaining to have it be third person. Come on.
I don't think so.
Break her out of it, because, like, I'm clicking, man. I'm clicking. I know you can beat her with her, beat an exchange with her. Basically, you just have to attack faster than she does. That's what breaks you through. I'm clicking. I'm sure the microphone can pick it up. Take advantage of those opportunities while she's away.
I don't.
I guess she can kind of speed up too.
I don't think so.
I'll get her. She may have the quick attack, and she may have other things, but I've got the force on this. If I die again, I'm going to take a quick pause and check on some tech stuff. I'm going to beat it today, but... she got me. Okay, just gonna hit escape real quick. Alright, we're back. I went and saved, exited out of the game, checked to make sure the footage was working properly, and then kind of came back in. So I haven't fought her yet, but the clips are going to be a little off. Let's jump into it. What? We don't save scum during bosses though, so I'm not taking advantage of that. Gotcha.
Don't. Mercy.
The kind of mercy you showed Jan?
She lives. I can tell you where she is.
Liar. I saw her die.
Think. What did you really see? What did you really hear? Do you believe we'd risk killing one of the only two people who knew the location of the Valley of the Jedi?
Where is she?
That... hauler will take you to our base in the Lenico Belt. That's where Gallic's ship, the Doomgiver, is docked. It's also where he's keeping your woman for further interrogations.
Why should I believe you?
Because I'm not brave enough to die!
Get out of my sight.
What?
You heard me. Go and pray that I find your master before he finds you.
What do you think? Should we have killed her if we had a chance?
Thanks for the help, Lando. But I thought you were going to be working with the security forces.
I was, but I got a better idea. What are you doing in that hauler?
I'm heading for the Lenico Belt.
Lenico? What's Tassan doing there? That asteroid belt is in the middle of nowhere.
I don't know, but I'm going to find out. Jan may be there.
Jan's alive?
Maybe. I don't know. Listen, you've got to find Skywalker and tell him that the Valley of the Jedi has been invaded.
What? What's the Valley got to do with this?
Just tell him.
Okay, I don't understand half of it, but okay. May the Force be with you, Kyle.
We'll see.
May the Force be with us indeed.
Transport 1-138 on final approach to Cairn installation. Cortosis removal unit, please stand by to board transport ship.
Affirmative, sir. Cortosis removal team standing by.
Cortosis is the one that's resistant to lightsabers. Cool. Once again, that is today's part. We've kind of gotten a ways through the game now. We're definitely past the halfway point, but I'm not sure how much longer we've got left. Either way, it's going to be quite a bit of fun, and I hope you've had fun joining me. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you are enjoying what I do here, and if you don't, you can leave a comment. Let me know. Take care, you guys. We'll see you.